trespassing.
You want to give me a little narration there, Cameron? Give me the history.
Leaving Mitchell County, going into Yancey County right here.
That old girl on New Mercy, like this other guy, she dated all of us.
I'm gonna go on this side.
Just over here?
Yeah.
They don't have a pusher behind it.
I don't.
Must not have been that heavy of a load.
Oh yeah.
Have a cabin up here.
Cabin just to come up here and hunt and hike down to the river and fish.
Get away from it all.
Take care of it.
God, Mark Fox lived here for 2 months.
2 months.
What's that, sir? 2003. I can never remember.
It's Mark's gloves. Yeah, you at least buying it.
When they moved here, it was in the 1860s, and it was just one county, it was Yancey County. And Yancey County and Mitchell County split in 1861 because Mitchell County was for the south and Yancey County was for the north. And these guys, families, they lived in Mitchell County when they had split. So, of course, they were for the northern aggressors, as we call them. And so they got run down in here pretty much. And there was a group of about 30 of them, 30 families, so that's a lot. And they built all these houses down here. And they lived down here fine until they moved out in the late 1940s. There's a couple of things led to their demise. First off, the state would not build a road down here. They would not run electricity down in here. Their main source of income, which was American chestnut, had got the blight and was dying away, so there was no logging left for the American chestnut. And the thing that probably put the nail in the coffin for them was that the railroad took out the passenger train. And as we leave and we walk on the railroad, you'll see the spur for the passenger train. And they discontinued that right at the beginning of the World War II. So when that happened, they were just isolated, so they had to move out, because the only way to get in here then was walk. They did have a store and a church and a couple of vehicles down here that they'd brought down on the passenger train and brought up here. You'll see a couple of vehicles down here. But so by the mid-40s, late-40s, they were all gone. And this is all that's left of it. It's all in private hands.
Or not, it looks like it was on there.